In this tutorial, we'll walk a new D&D player through the Roll20 Dungeons & Dragons character sheet and give you an overview of what you can do. Now, first things first, to start playing D&D on Roll20, you have to have an account. So go to roll20.net and create a new account. Now, don't worry, it's free and it takes seconds to set up. See, I signed up while I was saying that last sentence. Now, for this scenario, you've been invited to a D&D game on Roll20. You were either emailed a game link or you received a game link another way. Go ahead and click that link. It leads to your game's launch page. This is where you can add notes, schedule games, and adjust any settings. We'll go over that in a different video, but right now, click Launch Game. Now that your game's open on Roll20, go to the top right corner of the screen and click the second icon from the right that looks like a newspaper. This is the journal section. The journal section will have your character sheets and any handouts that your GM might want to share with you. Your GM might have assigned you a pre-made character or is going to walk you through a character master build. Either way, your new character will be in this section. If it's not, ask your GM to share your character with you by clicking Edit on the character sheet, assigning it to your journal, and allowing you to edit. It looks like our GM did share a character with us and is allowing edits. Let's click on our character's name, or shift-clicked on the character's token. This will open up your character sheet. Now, since this is a pre-made character sheet, we're good to go. If your character sheet doesn't look like this, your GM might be planning to walk you through a character building process. Check out our Character Mancer video in the description below. Now, looking at our character sheet, it might look a little overwhelming with all those numbers and math, but it's really not, especially because everything is click to roll and Roll20 does the math for you, so you can focus on the game. So let's say your GM tells you to roll a stealth check. Simply click the word stealth. Roll20 will roll the check for you and add your modifiers for you. You can see the results for your roll in the chat section, located in the top right corner by the icons with the two talking bubbles. If you want to see a breakdown of your rolls, hover your mouse over your roll total and a box will appear showing your initial roll and everything that was added to it. Now, you might have noticed two dice rolled when I clicked that button. This character sheet is automatically set up to roll with advantage when created. If you want to change that, click on the gear icon next to spells at the top right of your character sheet. Right below the now red gear icon, you'll see roll queries, always roll advantage. Click on that and you can change your preference. Now, in your game, a battle might break out and your GM might ask you to roll initiative. Like most things on the character sheet, all you need to do is click the word initiative in the top center of your sheet. But before you do, make sure you click on your player token first. Doing this will make sure that your character is added to the turn order. Awesome! Now that our character is in initiative, we might end up attacking. So let's say it's your turn and you want to attack with your Warhammer. Great! Click the Warhammer. The results will show up in chat. Now, the first number is your roll with modifiers. The second number is if you had advantage or disadvantage. And if we click the Warhammer text in the chat, we will roll damage for this weapon. By clicking just the Warhammer button, we now have the results on whether or not we hit, what happened if we had advantage or disadvantage, what type of damage we're dealing, and how much damage is being dealt. Perfect. Now, your character sheet has a lot of fillable fields also, from hit points to armor class, personality traits, and inventory. Simply click on any of these to type in changes. In order to add some fields, like personality traits, you need to click on the gear icon in the top right first. Then you can type in the field. There you go. If you need to add an item or proficiency, you can do so by clicking the plus button in the bottom left of the box. Then fill in the name of what you're adding. Let's climb. If you ever add something to your inventory by mistake, or maybe you lose an object, you can delete it by simply clicking the lock button at the bottom right corner of the inventory. You'll see little red trash cans appear next to each item. Click on the trash can next to the item you want to get rid of, and boom, it's gone. When you're done, don't forget to click the lock button so you don't accidentally delete something important. If we head over to the features and traits section, we'll notice that the titles are clickable as well. Clicking on a feature or trait will expand that information on your character sheet. The talk bubble to the right of the title will send this information into the chat for all the players to see. and the gear icon to the right of the bubble will allow you to edit that field. Now, let's say maybe you're a spellcaster, and your GM tells you you can choose a new spell. Head on over to the top right corner of your character sheet and click on Spells. Here we have a list of all our characters' spells. Clicking the title of the spell is the same as using it. Clicking the talk bubble adds it to our chat for other players to see. And clicking the eye icon expands the details of the spells so we can read up a little bit more on it. Now you can always add spells manually if you want by clicking the plus icon, or you can just drag and drop your spells straight from the compendium. To do so, go to the top right hand corner of the screen and click the eye icon in the middle. This is the compendium section. Here you'll be able to find anything from the books your GM has made available to you. We're looking for spells, so scroll down and click the spells button. We can search by name, or we can click the filter results button and search by a range of other options. When we find the spell that we like and want to add it to our game, just click and hold the spell and drag it over to your sheet. It will automatically go into the spell section. Now you're ready to start casting. Lastly, as you adventure, your character will level up. If your GM asks you to level up before the next game, you can level up by using the Character Mancer. On the character sheet, click the gear icon in the top right corner. It's right next to spells. Then scroll down at the bottom. Click on Launch Level plus Character Mancer. The Character Mancer will walk you through your options. For more details on the Character Mancer and leveling up, check the description below. And there you have it. Now you're ready to start adventuring with your Roll20 character sheet in tow.